Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Daryna and today I want to show you how glitter photographs in different lighting. So today I'm going to show you some results that I got shooting glitter in daylight, just the soft daylight like right now you guys see in this video, so just window light, soft light, strobe, and hard light strobe, as well as mixed lighting conditions as continuous light and a strobe. Also, I threw in a few effects like star filter and diffraction grading foam. So I really hope you guys will enjoy this video because we're gonna be comparing same color glitter, same placement with different lighting situations side by side. So I wanna show you the glitter that I used for this experiment, and it is Carlo Cosmetic Sapphire Gem. So as you guys can see, this is like a blue purple color. This glitter is really fine. It's a good quality cosmetic grade. So I picked this particular particle size because it's harder to capture. So the larger the glitter, the easier it is to capture its sparkling abilities and other features. So the first lighting that I put it to the test with was daylight. And it's the lighting that you guys can see on me right now. It's a light that's coming through the window. It's very soft, it's indirect. So here are the photos that I took with this lighting. So we can see some of the shine. It's not very bright. We can definitely see the color. We see some hints of the holographic effect, but it's not so strong, not as strong as I would like for it to be. So the next light that I put to the test was Profoto D2 with 2 feet OCF beauty dish. I treat that modifier like a softbox. It doesn't give me enough of the beauty dish qualities, and maybe it's just my personal opinion, but I treat it more like a 2 feet softbox. Here on these photos, we can see that sparkle is a little bit more obvious and more particle pick up that light and reflect it back. Holographic effect is more vivid compared to the daylight photos. Now we have to notice that, or I have to mention that the 2 feet source is smaller than the window that I have and the light coming through the window. So the smaller the source, the hotter the light. And with this experiment, you guys will notice that the hotter the light, the more obvious holographic effect gets. So here, despite it's obviously softer light than a bare bulb, but it's probably hotter than the window light, so holographic effect is more obvious. Here I added a reflector in order to see if I can maybe get a little bit more of the holographic effect, and I wasn't getting it. I got a little bit more of that color, made it more visible. Now I added star filter on top of my lens with this softbox on. We can't see any sparkle. We can't see that star that we're expecting from it. Pictures got softer, and instead of a sparkle on the most reflective pixels, on the most reflective particles, we see glare. We don't see that actual star that we're going for. These next photos were taken with Profoto D2 with just bare bulb. So what we can see here is that lighting got much hotter. We can see holographic effect more obvious, and more pieces pick up that light and reflect it back. So we can see harder reflection in the glitter. Also, we see that glitter got grittier. So with the softer light, we saw that whole design is just like one fluid piece. Right now, it looks a little sandy, a little bit more gritty. To take these photos, I added star filter to the lens because I wanted to see how this glitter looks in the hard light with the star filter. So, images got a little foggy. We can't see much of a star effect. If I zoom in, certain particles give us that star effect, but still it looks a little soft, which made me think that I should increase the distance between myself and the light because probably I was standing too close to the source. So we can make lighting appear hotter by increasing the distance between the subject and the source, or we can decrease the size of the source itself. So once I increase the distance and then I saw that sparkle, that star that's being definitely captured in the reflection of the light in my eye, I realized that it's probably some glitter issue. So a little tip for you guys, if you're using glitter that's mixed with gel, like a gel-based glitter product, or oil-based glitter product, still creates a thin film that dulls the sparkle. So it may not be as noticeable to the naked eye, but definitely noticeable to the camera. Now, a little trick that I do, I get same glitter in a loose form, and I sprinkle on top of the design. That glitter, not being mixed with any of the bases, it sparkles really well and it creates that beautiful, beautiful star effect. So this was one of the first images I took with that dry glitter, loose glitter sprinkled on the design. So that's trick number one. In case your glitter is not picking up, in case your star filter is not picking up the sparkle from your glitter, add some loose glitter to your design. So once I created those photos with stars, I was so happy. It was one of the successful moments of this experiment. Now I decided that I need to take some long exposure photos because that's another way of shooting glitter. I really enjoy it, especially when it's larger particle glitter. It looks really beautiful in photos. So in order to create that long exposure, that look of the glitter being dragged across the frame, I need to create mixed lighting conditions. So my prophoto stayed where it was, nothing changed there, but I also added NEN light to serve as my continuous source in order to create that movement, that light trail. So as I flip through these photos, you guys can see me experimenting. I'm very fair skin, so at a certain point, my entire skin was dragged across the frame. That's something that I didn't want to achieve. So I try to play a little bit with exposure and find that sweet spot for the time of exposure in order to only get effect, or like the most obvious effect, on the glitter, not on the skin. Another thing that I decided to do is to create a combo. So I put the star filter on the lens and then I used long exposure. And what that gave me, a cute little setup when glitter looks like it's just a bunch of shooting stars going across the night sky. It was super exciting. It's very fun, super pretty. So in this photo, you guys can see sparkles, but you can also see that light trail. So it kind of looks like just shooting stars. Very pretty. Now, another thing that I use a lot in my glitter work, and something that I really, really like, is diffraction grading. Diffraction grading is something that I won't be going in depth about, first and foremost, because I don't know much about it. You guys can Google and see professionals explain you what that is, but in a few words, it can be a piece of glass or a piece of plastic that has numerous edges on it, just like cut in lines that serve as prism. You can buy it on Amazon as a sheet, or you can buy it as diffraction glasses. So the glasses that I used in the very beginning was called Glow Effects. You guys can go check them out. Also, if you YouTube it, you can see other people creating cool stuff with these glasses. So just check out what people do. Anyways, first thing that happened is I saw zero effect, and it was a little scary because it never failed me. And that same day I had a conversation with a girl on Instagram, and she's like, hey, you know, so I bought this diffraction grating and I can't get it to work. And I'm like, well, you know, your light has to be hard light, and then your subject, whatever you're shooting, has to produce strong enough reflection. So I'm like, I know that stuff, you know, and I'm trying to shoot it over and over again and it doesn't work. Anyways, I grabbed just a pack of glitter and put it in front of the camera just to see if it's the actual diffraction grating film that doesn't work, or maybe it's the product that I'm having on my eye does not reflect enough of light. And obviously it was the reflection that wasn't strong enough. So another trick for you guys, in case reflection is not strong enough and the same size glitter doesn't do it for you, get the glitter of the same kind but larger particle. I didn't have the same kind glitter on my hands. I had a blue glitter, but it was not holographic, so I'm like, oh, I'm just gonna try it. So what I did, I sprinkled it here and there. I put it on the areas that stick out the most, so basically areas that's supposed to pick up the most light and bring back or give back enough reflection. You guys can see that it's working. I'm getting that holographic or starburst effect, but the problem about it is that you can clearly see that that piece does not belong to the design. Like, that glitter just not a part of the design. It was just put there for, you know, whatever reason. So I tried to play with it a little bit and I realized that I don't like that. So I started thinking about what could be another solution. And here's where I came up with. Because the biggest thing they gave out this whole chunky glitter was first, not having the holographic quality, and then second, being way too large. So I needed glitter that was a little bit smaller. I didn't have it in blue, but I had translucent glitter that was mimicking that holographic quality. It was just like glitter of different colors. It was see-through. So what I decided to do, I sprinkled some of that glitter on my eyes, and then I thought, because lighting is so hard, it will go right through it to the blue, so then we won't see that this glitter is translucent, that that glitter does not belong to the design. But because it's this dry glitter and it's really sparkly and it's larger, it will help me to produce that rainbow starburst that I was looking for. So that's exactly what I did. And right off the bat, images started looking just like I wanted them to look. Now, if you guys zoom in, you will be able to see that this is larger glitter, but because it's translucent, it's not as obvious as that blue big chunky piece. Another thing that I like to do, I like to use all of my effects, so I added star filter to it and diffraction grading, and I was getting beautiful starburst because that glitter that I just applied is bigger, so the star is even larger, and then I was getting the rainbow halos. I was super happy about it. So you guys can see that there's science behind shooting glitter, and there's definitely tricks of the trade that you can implement in order to get the desired effect. This was my experiment, you guys. You saw how I used different light setups in order to shoot glitter and how different it looks. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please subscribe to my channel, click that like button, and I hope to see you in my next videos. Bye bye.